in order to do a split log, first you've got to have time on your 70 hours and time in your driving hours to do it. So the first thing you need to have is 10 hours consecutively off duty. That's the first part of it. That way you have a full break in before you actually start split logging. If you don't have a full 10 hours consecutively off duty, the ELD or the OmniTrax will not split log you. You want to stop. After your 10 hours consecutively off duty, you get up and you go to work and you drive, let's say 5 hours. And you decide to get unloaded. And you decide at that point you want to take a break. Your first break at that point has to be no less than 8 hours in the sleeper berth. At that point, when you come back to the driving area, you can come straight back down and drive for 6 hours because your split driving time will be, it's gotta be 11 hours. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So your next break, your next driving time will be 6 hours. 4, 5, 6. At that time, the OmniTrax is going to tell you you have to take another break. Your next break must be no less than 2 hours. Either in the sleeper or off duty. Either one is sufficient. At the end of that 2 hour break, when you come back down to work or to drive, actually, you're gonna get your 5 hours that you started with back. Stop. At the end of that driving period, you must go back into the sleeper to continuing, if you're going to continue your split log, for 8 hours. And if you're going to continue to drive at that point, you'll have 6 hours to drive. Then you're gonna have to take another break, which is gonna have to be no less than 2 hours, into the sleeper.
So does this have to be like straight fives and eights and twos and?
No, you can add your driving time. You can break your driving time up in any amount of time that you want. It doesn't have to be five and six. I'm just using that for the class. You can go 2 hours and then 9 hours. It doesn't really matter. The OmniTrax will calculate all your time. What really matters is your break time. Your first break must be no less than 8. Your second break must be no less than 2. And it really doesn't matter if you take your 2 hour break in the sleeper here or your sleeper here in the off duty position.
So any break or sleeper berth can be taken either off duty or sleeper berth, like?
No.
No.
Your 8 hours must be in the sleeper.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Stop. Trish asked me if it had to be 5 and 6 or 6 and 5. It doesn't. As long as you start with 8 hours in the bunk, your time can be, your driving time can be 6, 7, 8. And then if you're gonna take your break then, take your break either off duty or in the sleeper berth, for no less than 2 hours. Then you're going to come back. Then what you're going to have left of your 11 hours of driving is going to be 3 hours. Then you must go back into the sleeper for 8 hours minimum.